another rubbish time-lapse. Yes, it's... Such was the outrage of Sandy and I trying to change the title of our series. I've decided to change the title back to Modular Mondays, even if the films don't come out on Mondays. Most of you don't watch them on Mondays, only 1/7 of you do, so I reckon, does it really matter? It does have a better ring to it. You were absolutely right. This week, I'm going to try and work more on this patch that I was kind of work in progress last week. I had a problem. I compared it to kind of setting up some IKEA furniture and getting the first piece in the wrong way around. Doesn't mean I'm going to have to take the whole patch to pieces and start from scratch. Well, let's go down to the shed and have a look. So what I thought I'd do is I'd whip out the Morphinogene sampler by Make Noise, which I still haven't got my head around, and replace it with this Tempi that used to live in this skiff, but again, haven't got my head around. There's something about Make Noise that just make me frightened. So I plugged this up, and the problem I had with this patch was basically we were clocking everything to eighth notes off 40 BPM, which meant that the kind of pulsing bass was correct. The reason I wanted it this slow is if you look at the Rene, I'm basically holding these pitches for quite a long time, and that's a subdivision of eighth notes. So what I decided to do was double the rate of everything, go up to 80 BPM, make the click eighths of 80 BPM, a much more manageable thing where I could do a variety of beats and sequences, ostinatos, that kind of stuff. But I thought I'd subdivide the click even more with this Tempi. How does it work? Well, actually, it turns out it's very simple. You have your click going in here, the tempo it calls it, and then you have basically six channels that respond differently to that tempo depending on the preset. So basically, if we go up here, you'll see this will start responding differently, and you can basically program these presets, goodness knows how. Let me go up here. Now, I'm really looking forward to using this in the future and having a different oscillator running off all of these different types of presets, which you can also send CV. So let's try and get back to where we were. So that's just basically duplicating. And basically you'll see that this super slow one here, I've actually got the axis in the Rene, which is doing this really slow switch of notes in the bass, which is going boom, 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 is now being controlled by this slow one here. That's basically it. So the main sequence, if we have a listen here, it's coming out at the Atlantis. So that's just going bang in with the eights there. Everything's getting exactly the same CV pitch information from the Metropolis, but we're subdividing the click via this MMS device and also the Tempi. So this is the MCO. I've got the Atlantis on a very slow filter. And this is the MCO. And then I've got the pluck. Which has kind of got a triplet feel to it. The hi-hat from the Chimera. And I've also got a bass on this submixer here. So same speed, but a massive subdivision on the different pitches, which are defined by the Rene. Is this patch finished? Well, I'm not entirely sure the way I've got the piano pedals rigged up. A whole bunch of Strymons and loop pedals and my sustain pedal. I think I'm trying to make the best out of too many worlds. So whilst I'm going to run this patch down today, I do think I'll probably have another go at it before trying to mix it out of the box.
There is a super fat new sequence in the DFAM though. Last week I also mentioned that I might be making an announcement. This is quite an interesting one to make really, but basically the modular experiment that I've embarked on, I've not been totally clear with you about. In fact, what I'm trying to do is release a series of albums. The first of which is going to be the kind of stuff that you've been hearing, a mixture of pianos, modular stuff, me working solo, occasionally with other people, to do what I would call a throat clearer of an album before embarking on something which I'm really excited about, which is a series of experimental pieces. And what I love about the challenge of making experimental music is to also make it listenable. So this first album is an opportunity for me to understand and experience this out-of-the-box experiment, because I want all of my albums to be out of the box, but also to learn firsthand how it is that you go about releasing an album. Now, surprisingly, I'm not going to do this through Spitfire recordings, because I do see this as a kind of an experimental kind of project. I don't want to be committed to a record deal. But what I will be doing is releasing the record myself on my own record label. And I thought not only would it be fun for you to see the genesis of the album here from the kind of technical stuff I'm doing with the modular rig, the out of the board mixing, but also what it takes in this day and age to set up your own little mini label and release your own stuff. Maybe even to a hard copy. I've got some mentors at Spitfire Audio who are going to guide me through the process, and I too will share that information. I think there's many budding composers out there who want to do media work, but also understand the importance of being seen as an artist in your own right. It's taken me 25 years to get to this point, and it is both a combination of this strange space age 1960s technology and this vlog which is motivating me on to finally pull my socks up and do it.
Right, let's have a look at this patch, do a little bit of a performance. I think we're going to track it today but not mix it, because one of my lunch boxes still isn't working. Hopefully we'll get back to it next week to show you how I go about mixing out of the box. Okay, here we go. Thank you. Thanks as always for watching, and I do promise in future to limit my kind of daddy jigging. If you're not subscribed, please do. Lots of interesting stuff coming up. If you want to be notified the next time I put up a film, ding that bell. And one of those, always massively appreciated. See you next week.